up, everybody? It's your boy, this is my sneakerhead in the house, coming with a brand new video. Before we get started, please hit that thumbs up, comment, subscribe, share. Truly appreciate all the support. We are at episode 11, folks, of Last Seven Kicks, so I truly appreciate all the support. Again, I have my new mic on. I did some adjustments that people recommended in the comments, and I do appreciate it. So let me know if I sound better, worse, same, and I'll continue tweaking my DSLR and mic accordingly. But without further ado, let's get right into it. Sunday, your homeboy wore a very talked about piece in terms of kicks, but I wear these a lot. And we have the KD6 Grandma's Couches, aka Florals. This was the EXT model, so it had the extra cushioning on the tongue. The insole is cushioning, and this has like a not even a mesh or nylon. It's almost like I can't even describe the feel, but it feels like grandma's couch. I absolutely love this shoe. Initially, I was like, this is hideous. But when they dropped, I'm like, you know, there's something really dope about these. So I copped them. I wear these a lot. I had the nice, like, flat black wax laces. Super, super dope. As you can see, I wear them a lot. And everybody always talks about them when I have them on. But this is what I wore on Sunday. Monday, I busted out a pair of kicks that I haven't worn in a while. Got these for 70, 80 bucks on Soul Supremacy's eBay website 2 years back. We have the Penny 5 Cloaks in the house. Yes, these joints are flames right here, man. Absolutely love this. This is really the only colorway of the Penny 5 that I liked. There were other decent ones, but this one's the dope. That iridescent cloak feel that it has to where it changes color, where it's blue, green, purple. Of course, the glow-in-the-dark bottom, you can't beat that. Tuesday was no dress down. We had clients in, so it was business casual. So I just wore these polo sneakers slash shoes. Some people call them sneakers. Some people call them shoes. Super dope. Very plain. Gum bottom. Not much branding. You just have the polo there on the back, and then you have the polo horse on the tongue. Canvas-type feel to it, but I could wear these all day because they're super comfortable. But yeah, nothing crazy. This is what I wore on Tuesday. Wednesday, I busted out a pair of Air Maxes. We have the Air Max Ones. Now, this was on clearance back in 2013 on Nike.com. I got this for 55 bucks. Super, super dope. Synthetic leather, synthetic suede. Nothing crazy in terms of materials. The swoosh and the midsole speckling is 3M, so it pops nicely on camera. But yeah, just the shoes, I've worn these a lot of times. The last one reason I love Air Maxes, to wear them with anything. Thursday, yet again, we had clients in, so again, no dress down. So I wore a pair of Sperry Topsiders, aka boat shoes, whatever you want to call them. Love this color, super comfortable. Sperry's are some of the most comfortable shoes out there, to wear them with or without socks. Nothing crazy about the color. They're always usually very simple colors, but the material's great. Got this for 40 bucks from DSW. Friday, as you know, it's Foam Fridays. And I have a suggestion. Let me know down below if you want me to do a separate Foam Fridays series. Every Friday, I'll try my best to wear a pair of foams and do an on foot of them and post it on my channel. So let me know if you guys want to see that down below. But Friday, I wore the Air Foam Posit 1 Orlando Magic. This was originally an unreleased PE that Penny wore, I believe, at, correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it was an all-star game in Orlando, and he rocked these. Super dope. It came in that pack with the low Penny Posits, which are absolutely atrocious. Nobody rocks those. I wore those one time just to un-DS them. And they're trash. Nobody wanted those, but these were super dope. 3M on the stars, super clean. That icy bottom, again, you can't go wrong. This was executed flawlessly. But yeah, this is what I wore on Friday. The Air Foam Posit 1 Orlando Magics is what I'll call them. Saturday, your homeboy wore the Air Jordan 4 Cement 4s. Now, this one was the, I believe, the 2012 release. Let me see here. Yeah, it looks like it was the 2011 or 2012 release. This pair doesn't have the Nike Air on the tongue, and it doesn't really look as anywhere near the original compared to the 2016 pairs that dropped earlier this year. I do have a pair of those, but those are sitting on ice, and I'm just going to rock these and beat these. But yeah, the quality was bad on these. Leather was super hard, not very comfortable. And again, the cement and everything, the color was just off. But I got these for $140 back in 2013 when I just started getting back into kick, summer 2013. So to get these for $140, you cannot beat it. Still a dope shoe on feet, just nothing near the quality of the 2016s that released. But anyway, folks, that is it. Appreciate all the support again. Stay tuned next week for episode 12 of Last 7 Kicks. And with that being said, it's your boy, the Smart Sneakerhead, and my brother is out. Peace.